All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the stream for Dynascapes International. Sorry, Dynascapes Intermediate Cup. I am so sorry. I messed that up. But now we are going to be going to, I believe, the final quarterfinals match, which should be Splendor of Tranquil Waters versus the Ballers. We're seeing some really familiar faces here, so I am really excited to see how this one goes. I'm Silvas Kaels, and commentating with me is going to be Nightcore. Hello, how are you doing today?
Hello, well, I'm doing very well today as well. You know, it's definitely a splendid match to be, you know, closing off on, especially as I did see both these teams perform, and, well, they're both very strong teams, but one team is going to be making it towards the next round, which is going to be the semifinals. So, can't wait to see that.
Well, I mean, here's the thing. These two teams, well, seed 14, seed 16, it's a very close seeding battle here. I can't wait to see how these two are going to perform. Is it one of those matches where you can't really expect a clear differential in terms of their skill set? But I guess we can look at the statistic sheet, but could you provide some information if possible?
Yep, just looking at it now. Sorry, it's just kind of hard to see. It seems Ballers are very good on LN, as they do have very good seedings in LN1 and LN2. You know, I do know the LN1 picks are usually frowned upon by a lot of players in this tournament, so it would definitely be interesting to see how they perform and how Splendor Tranquil Waters will react in this situation. Meanwhile, for Splendor Tranquil Waters, actually, they are fairly good at LN density as well, coming fourth overall in LN2. But we don't know yet if their release is as capable compared to Ballers, so we'll just have to see.
I mean, I am aware of Gahiti 2 Noob from, I believe that was Cold Open Cup, and I've seen Poyi, but there's also Log45VS, who, once again, I've also seen. Like, these are players that, for the most part, are very familiar, and we've seen them whether or not they're staffing or playing in general. So it would be interesting to see how they would put the playing experience into this match, because they'll definitely need that. This is a very close seeding, after all.
Yeah, definitely, as you did say that. Potentially, we could see another tiebreaker as well, just judging on, well, how close the seeds are and how well they're both performing in general. I do know as well that, as I just do kind of whip up into more statistics, okay, sorry, I just got a bit carried away. So, I don't know if Ballers have played. Okay, it does seem that Ballers have played. So, it did seem like that their last match was facing against C27 Volcano, where they have knocked them out in a 5-2 victory. In that case. So, they're just moving on to their final conditional losers bracket for today to see if they will be making it into the semis. Meanwhile, as we are seeing now, well, we're just in warm-ups, so I guess that does just give us more time to talk about some of the teams as well. So, looking off by, I actually don't really see much scores from, is there any scores from Ballers for some of the race picks? I don't see any, actually. Oh well, it's okay, I guess. So, they're actually also fairly good hybrid as well. As, you know, yeah, it has a fairly solid score in Hybrid 1. You know, for Splendor Tranquil Waters, I don't really see any of their hybrid scores for the round 16. Also, the quarterfinal stats have not been shown yet, probably because they're not finished at all. But, you know, we're just going to have to see how they perform again. So, we're just getting into the second one now, which is going to be Save Back. This is actually an Epic Man match, one of our fellow commentators as well. So, if you're here, Epic Man, hi. Well, if we can get a small insight of the runner for two statistics. Let me just whip it up real quick.
Go ahead. What were you saying?
So, as I was saying, Ballers do show some rise capabilities as well, as they are fairly good on kind of more the pure streamy picks, and also fairly decent at the technicality pick, which they could probably use that again to capitalize on Ballers if they're fairly comfortable. But I am taking this from the round of 32, and as you all probably know, that mid game is a lot different from early game. So, you know, we are stepping up that difficulty quite a bit when it comes from two rounds apart. But I guess we haven't really got much info on their performance in round of 16 other than LN. So we're just going to have to see, as I did say.
All right. I mean, you did already mention a lot of statistics and information that would be important. But here's the thing. One of my biggest concerns is if the difficulty ramping up would affect the performance of these two teams. Because it looks like Splendor of Tranquil Waters, at least if you were to compare it to the Ballers, had a much better average if you were to compare those two. But now that we're looking here, another thing that interests me is how rank is actually very close, with Ballers having a 2.64 average rank while Splendor having 2.91. So that just goes to show, or at least from how I understand the chart, I think that just means the Ballers team had some very low scores, but also some very high ones. I mean, I could definitely be wrong for that. But if that's the case, then I would really be interested to see how everyone performs here. Just the disparity of skill sets being very close and not that obvious because of the seed disparity, I think it's already enough for me to say that this could really be a close match.
Yeah, I see a tiebreaker, honestly. I don't even know if all the round 16 stuff are updated unless they did, unless the Ballers have played. Hybrid, as I've double checked the rice and it doesn't seem that they have played it, so it's just gonna be interesting to see. So do you have any more predictions for this match, as we do kind of, you know, we're still kind of in the warm-up phase?
Okay, so if you're talking about predictions now, it's going to be a little bit hard for me to make a prediction on the rice part, because the Ballers primarily played long notes in the hybrids, it seems, when we're looking at the round of 16 sheet, at least from what I've observed. However, if you were to look at, let's say qualifiers, I guess. I mean, if we were to look at the Ballers and what was that again? Splendor? It looks like Splendor has a slight Splendor has a very evident advantage when it comes to the rice picks, because rice 1, rice 2 was a clear difference, and as for rice 3, it looks like they are literally just one seed apart, with Splendor being slightly higher. Meanwhile, for Ellen's, it looks like it's gonna be close, but slight edge once again goes to Splendor. I mean, honestly, every category except for hybrid would go to Splendor. So Ballers might have to, you know, capitalize on the hybrid pick.
Yeah, I totally agree with what you said. See, honestly, just because of how well balanced both of the teams are, as you did, excluding kind of Rice 1 and Rice 2, I definitely think it is going to be more of a consistency game, honestly. So yeah, we're just going to have to see if all the players are fairly comfortable with this map. And as we do conclude the warm-ups, we are going to get in two deep roles.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, once again, just looking at all of the players, it could be close. It could definitely be close and all that. But consistency is going to be a big factor here. I mean, looking at this map alone, you can see accuracy-wise might go to Splendor slightly, but the ratio the racial potential was on the Ballers.
Yeah. Again, I don't really know what to say. As he did say, it's going to be a close match. And we're going to jump into the protects and bans. And it does seem that Ballers are going to win the role with getting an 87, a 5-point difference compared to Spender. So they're going to pick the first protect. As you do know, this is going to be ABBA format, which Ballers will be getting the first protect, but that will give Spender Trample Waters the first ban. So they're going to be going for Rice 6 protect, which honestly, I don't know really what to think about that. What do you think?
It's crazy to me that they're going for a Rice 6 protect, because my biggest concern is they're really banking on that accuracy. Wait a second. Actually, wait. Considering that on the warm-ups, it looked like the Ballers had the slight ratio advantage, I can see why they'd protect Rice 6.
Honestly, yeah, just kind of more going into it, I do see why as well. I'm not comfortably familiar with this map pool, as I didn't really get much first-hand experience down for it. But I kind of can't just get a general understanding of the maps. So yeah, we're just going to be finishing off now into the protects and bans, and it does look like LN3 is going to be banned, and Rice3 is going to be banned as well.
Okay, so let's analyze this. Let's analyze this real quick, okay? Give me a sec. So, I mean, so they're banning. So Ballers ban LN, Spender bans Rice. Very interesting for me that they're going for that route. However, if we were to compare Splendor and the Ballers team, like, if I'm just trying to see how both teams are doing, I'm looking for a map which both teams played, and what do you think, actually? Okay, we have Lost Without You, where it looks like Splendor actually slightly has the advantage. So that just begs the question, why would you ban a Rice when it looks like Rice's seem to be some of the things you could be on edge for even more?
Honestly, I just think it's more of what they're comfy with. But as he did say, yeah, I'm kind of confused on why they would do that as well. Especially if the other team manages to snag a breakpoint. That could be a bit of a red flag for, who picked this again? Ballers? Yeah. It could be a red flag for them, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, okay. So, riding at the walls. So, this team actually has a decent score on it, with only one miss, I believe. But you don't know what's the score of, what do you call this again, of Splendor on a map like that. So that's just, that they're really gambling this. But I don't think it's a good gamble, because you do not, again, you don't know how good they're gonna do. And if you're able to have a higher accuracy on the hybrids, which actually, according to the MP, it looks like Splendor still slightly has it. I guess they really are trying to go for options that they think could work. But again, this is just a gamble, because Splendor knows Ballers' score, but Ballers doesn't know Splendor's score.
Yeah, that's probably gonna raise a massive red flag again. You really just said everything that needs to be said, I guess, on that kind of D&D. But we're just gonna have to see. Again, personally, I think you would probably just go for what you're more comfortable with first, instead of kind of taking the gamble. Because especially if you do kind of show weaknesses this early in the map, it's gonna be very easy for the other team to capitalize on your weakness. So here we go, kicking into the first map.
This is already an interesting start for me, because we're already seeing how stable everyone is, with the exception of Fluffy. Same me too, getting a few 200s. So the thing about this map is it tests a lot of your consistency, and not to mention accuracy as well, because of those very tricky jumps and rolls that you're going to be attacked with. Not to mention those anchors as well. Gotta be very careful all around, but looks like Splendor and Ballers are just very much neck to neck.
Yeah. I do see a couple of 200s being traded back and forth, but nothing exactly too out of the ordinary yet. Azamop is kicking in fairly long with 3 minutes 26 seconds, and at that BPM as well, you're just going to have to be on your A game, especially with some of the actors like this, as it is fairly mixed in the Rice category. You just got to watch out in general for everyone.
Okay. Again. Lead is slightly on the baller side due to Seimitsu dropping a few 200s, which is already giving them a very slight edge. Even then, this is still nothing. Like, a single miss would really be able to dictate who takes lead. Though luckily right now, we're on the jump stream patterns. Okay, never mind. That anchor pattern could really make everyone drop, and unfortunately it's going to be attacking Left Fluffy.
Yep, especially with the accuracy advantage from ballers already. That miss is definitely not favoring Splendor. Again, you have to watch out for the anchors like this in this sort of type of map, as well, they can catch anyone off guard. Really.
The thing is, Saimitsu's accuracy is still well behind everyone else's. So even if LaFluffy did not miss there, the advantage would still be on the baller's side. It's not even decreasing any bit, even if Poity dropped a few more 200s. It's just a very technical map, where I'm really surprised how everyone's still keeping that consistency other than that one miss. So it's a really good job for everyone to hold on, and it looks like the baller's gamble has worked so well for them so far.
Yeah, you can definitely see by that, especially with the, just overall just with the stability, actually the Fluffy catching up back with the accuracy, but overall with just ballers with the higher accuracy and consistency, it's going to be hard for Splendor to catch up in this final quarter.
At the very least, at this rate, ballers are going to be performing better in terms of the consistency. I mean, sure, accuracy is slightly worse overall, but it looks like it's just on pace to be the same as before. So ballers has essentially performed the same way as yesterday, and that's already a good sign. But you have to remember, this is a pick that you're expecting Splendor to not do too well on, so you shouldn't really rely on that too much.
Yeah, especially with overall the performance on other Rice maps as well. Especially as we do compare it from the previous statistics, it definitely seems that they're more on par with the kind of more streamy picks. So yeah, this pick worked off for ballers, and it is going to be one that made his registry.
Consistency really paid off for the ballers. And that was certainly a great way to start things. But again, you can't rely on that too much. I think Splendor has to go for maybe Sagashimono. Because Sagashimono seems to be something that the Splendor team is really good at. But if you were to look at the ballers, their Sagashimono isn't too far behind, actually. Only like 20,000 points. And for a map like that, 20,000 points isn't that big of a difference because of how few nodes there are.
Yep. You probably did say that, right? So, now we're going to get into Slender's first pick, which they're picking Hybrid 2, which is going to be Zeke in for Interior Court. I did. Very awkward map for a Hybrid kind of pick.
Sorry, go ahead.
Kind of an interesting song and map, really. Especially, it is very technical. So if you're with technical releases, you have to be on your A game for this.
I don't like this pick, actually.
Yeah, fair enough.
I don't like this pick. What were we gonna say?
Map is weird. I do know the S. I do know the SV map. And again, it's still shares same with the weirdness. Especially with just awkward offbeats and this type of map as well.
I actually really don't like this pick for two reasons. If you were to look at the scores for both of the teams, like if you were to analyze it, Ballers actually performed slightly better in this map. Sure, it's only like 50 points or something like that, but you don't want to pick something that the opponent has a slight advantage on. But if you were to look at the accuracy side of things, say it looks like Sei Mitsu is able to secure a B1SS, but LaFluffy gets around the same 200s that Gahiri to Noob and Poity were able to get in the previous round. Not to mention, that was with two misses as well. So literally, this could really not pay off. So they're trying to counter a gamble with another gamble, which in my opinion, this one is slightly worse than the previous one.
Yeah, just looking at the statistics, I would totally have to agree with you there. It is, I think, one of the weaker picks I've seen for Splinter Trunk of Waters. Especially, I do especially just with more consistency. And yeah, that's what I am saying. Tometu dropping very early in the map. You have to be careful with this type of pick as well, which definitely gives an early accuracy advantage to Ballers. However, it is an early miss, so nothing too substantial yet.
I want to add as well that the previous pick kinda tells me that the Ballers are gonna perform just as good as how they did yesterday. But Splendor right now, it doesn't look like they're gonna have almost the same performance. LaFluffy has certainly improved the score a lot right now, but looking at the patterns that we saw, there could be more awkwardness in that.
Yeah, especially as now we're approaching kind of more the awkward map. Like, those reverse staggers, but Poity actually finding a drop in these reverse staggers, it might shift the lead back, but overall, yeah, actually is going to shift the lead back, as Gary Noob as well is going to find a few greats on those reverse staggers. I just have to watch out on them.
LaFluffy has been performing much better in this chart, so you gotta really give it to them. Not to mention Sei Mitsu at the same time also performing slightly better in the accuracy department. Both teams seem to be doing around the same level as yesterday, but Splendor, that accuracy was a big improvement. The second player act really helping right now. That early miss from Sei Mitsu just instantly gets cancelled out, especially after their Poity miss. Time is running out, and I think that's gonna do it. 1-2-1, I think, is gonna be the score, unless something bad happens here. And what an improvement that was for LaFluffy, who only had 974, now improves it by 11,000 points. Just enough for the score to be better than the Ballers. Had LaFluffy got the same score that they got yesterday, they would have won that by they would have lost that by 2,000 points.
Very good performance again. This tournament's just full of surprises for me. I think maybe mirror buff. Sorry, I was just looking at the last. I was just looking from yesterday without the mirror, and they're just looking today with the 11k score difference from mirror. Mirror buff really is real, guys.
I guess it does help, but honestly, it just begs the question. How well are these teams really holding up? Like, okay, so let's look at how this team performed today in comparison to the previous one. Okay, so it looks like both teams actually did better than yesterday, but it was a much better improvement for Splendor than the Ballers, and it was definitely obvious. Like, the 200 count was half for Splendor, but for the Ballers, it was almost the same amount. So gotta give them props where it's due. Countered a very good performance with their own very good performance, as now the Ballers try to cancel that point with Rice 1. I believe this is the more stamina jump stream oriented map, but I could be wrong.
Nope, you are correct. This is going to be the stamina map. It's going to be, you know, Rice 1s are usually typically known for, well, stamina jump stream pick.
What?
2 minutes?
Mm-hmm. 3 minutes, huh?
2 minutes long, yeah. Not really much room for error. Being kind of more on the shorter end of these types of maps as well. So, consistency is key. I definitely do see why Ballers picked this, as they have extremely good consistency and ratio as well. Maybe they might hope that Splendor will find a couple of misjudgments, even maybe some combo breaks for this map as well. But anything's on the board for a type of map like this.
I think this is a very questionable pick. I'm not sure what they're trying to go here. But if you were to look at these, the MP links, it's Splendor actually did better in this by around 19,000 points. So that's a red flag in my opinion.
Yeah, honestly, just looking at it now, I totally agree with you again. But as we did see in Hybrid 2, we could see maybe a potential prediction upset as well again. Although I do think Ballers are more of the consistent team, but again, anything is on the board. It is an entire different skill set compared to Hybrid 2.
I'm just saying though, even if it's a different skill set, I just don't know. Like, if you're performing 20,000 points worse compared to another team, why would you go for this? Like, I don't know about you, but that's a very bold move.
Yeah, I would probably have to agree with you in the sense of that as well. But, okay. So back to, again, finding the early drop, nothing too substantial as it is, only the intro, kind of finding more of a cleaner drop if I do remember correctly, only dropping a 200 along with that. So nothing, again, too big as we do kick off the map. But again, with a map length of 2 minutes, there's not much room for error. You just gotta hope that Ballers do find another combo break or a couple of misjudgments throughout the next minute and a half of the map.
Well, there is the miss that you just mentioned a while ago. And now, as the lead is going to start to pull over, but it's not going to be there for long because Ballers has the slight accuracy lead. They're performing much better, at least early on. But I think what I can observe is Saimitu is starting to drop a little bit. That stamina factor is really starting to get to them. But it's still really close. 5,000 points of difference. This is absolutely nothing, especially considering the structure of this map has a lot of chokeable parts, and it would really throw you off if you're not careful with those bursts. This could still go either way, and I think Splendor might actually lose it. So again, the Ballers gamble seems to be working once more.
Yeah, and especially with that final drop again from Sumetsu, only increasing that score gap for 20k as well, even with a couple of misjudgments from Pointy and a double drop from Sumetsu, I think it's going to seal the deal, as everyone is trading back misses, only having one full combo left on the board, as a map does come for a close, I definitely think. Yep, you're right, the gamble did.
The gamble did work, right? That was
yep, the gamble paid off. Well done.
That's such an anomaly. Like, if you were to look at the score, like, it's just a very much an anomaly, because that's a massive improvement, a 40,000 point improvement for the Ballers. Splendor had a minus 20,000 points performance. That was a massive difference. So what is going on? Like, I thought Splendor had it here when I was looking at the differences on the MP links, but it looks like the Ballers are just much better today on Ryze. Well, more well equipped and all that. And it's honestly really nice to see, but look, Splendor still has a couple more hybrids and two more long note maps, which I think they should be doing. Should be going for, in my opinion.
Yeah, honestly, I would totally have to agree with you. I think the way that it just probably works, that everyone is performing better than they were from the previous 2 days, I just think now, after they play the map pool, they're a bit more comfortable in all these types of maps. Even though you probably have played them before for practice, I still think, even just having the overall experience on a versus match on this style of map pool, really just kind of boosts your confidence a small bit. And they are going to jump into LN2. You were saying that they were probably going to be better off hopping into an LN or hybrid pick, which, yeah, but we'll probably have to agree with you. So this is going to be the density pick, actually.
This is the safest pick, I think, if you were to look at if we were to look at these two teams' performances once again, I don't think they played formless canvas. If there was a team that played formless canvas, it might have been the Splendor team. Yeah, Splendor has a 987 and a 970 in this, so solid performance already. But now, will Poigi and Gaidetu Noob be able to keep up? I think Gaidetu Noob is going to be the biggest concern here, because when we're looking at Sagashimono here, that's a 949,000 points of score for Gaidetu Noob with 40 grades. That's already a bad sign because of how slow that map is. And now you're greeted with a much more difficult fundamental-wise Ellen map. So it's going to be a big challenge for ballers here.
Yep, especially now just seeing in the chat that Gaidetu Noob can't Ellen. Well, it could raise a question again. Are ballers kind of are ballers fairly comfortable with this map? As especially from a map like this, it is very awkward. As you know, typical mint stealth fashion maps in some sort of this. I don't really have much to say other than let's just get this started.
Let's get started indeed, as now we are going to be looking for the fourth pick of the match, which is Formless Canvas. I mean, like what you said, this is an Ellen density pick. But what I'm mostly concerned about here is how will the stamina factor be placed in here? Because right now we're going to be seeing log 45 vs. Someone wasn't played much in this multi, I believe. So that player will have some rest in comparison to someone like Gaidetu Noob and Poigi. But that accuracy difference, it's slightly onto Splendor's advantage right now.
Yeah, especially looking at Smetsu's overall accuracy, onto that, holding onto that 971k, could potentially see a 990 in this type of pick, which would be very impressive if Smetsu does keep his consistency up. Actually, it is flickering back towards, as Gaidetu Noob does catch up on the accuracy specter, but Log just a bit far behind, a bit slightly behind onto that 99.2. It's got to be careful on these types of releases, especially just on some of those release bursts as well, where it can catch people out.
Log getting a lot of 200s. That is not looking good at all. Those density sections are actually helping ballers for the advantage, because now Saimitsu and Poigi are literally tied. The same accuracy with Gaidetu Noob's difference starting to make an impact on the scoreline. Now, are we going to be seeing the first breakpoint? Because it's looking like that, as Slug releases slightly early on the density section. That's very concerning. Unless someone misses on the ballers, it's really gonna go to Splendor, right? It's really gonna go to ballers right now, and it doesn't look like it's gonna get closer.
Yeah, I would totally have to agree. Log, again, just finding those late grades again. Fairly struggling on some of those releases as well. Again, awkward pick, I would definitely say. But at the end of the day, Baldur's was just way more consistent with that type of pick. Still four full combos on the board, but the accuracy advantage heavily favors Baldur's, especially with just that overall higher average.
Staimitsu had a much better ratio in the previous match, but just could not respond today. Very unfortunate, but it is what it is, and that's the first breakpoint with the ballers. Now, what do you go for? Like, now that you've lost an Ellen pick, I'm really concerned right now, because I think Sagashimono still could favor Splendor, but they're running out of picks already. I think ballers is gonna be going for Sprite. What they want from me, I think, is way too risky. Maybe go for something like Sprite or Lost Without You, actually.
They are going to go for Rice 6, as you did say, it was going to be more of a risky pick. Yeah, I probably have to agree with you on that one again. So let me actually just whip the stats as well.
Wait, they're going for what do you want from me?
Yep. I don't think both teams have played this map, if I do remember correctly from the previous. But again, that is kind of more the riskier pick. As you did say, I do think Rice 3 more favors them. Again. But we'll just have to see, honestly. It could raise a red flag in more taking gambles, because it's not going to work every time.
The thing about this map is, like, what I'm concerned about is they did play this, but they don't exactly have the best consistency, which is two misses. And for something like this map, it's very, very difficult to recover when you miss, especially with how straightforward most of the map is.
Yeah, I totally have to agree. And yeah, do correct me again, as bothers to play this map. I just kind of got confused on the background. So yeah, you don't really want to see this on.
And here we go.
Yep, we're really just gonna have to see what is going to be. We just have to see what's gonna happen.
I like how they're going for Luff Luffy and Log 45 VS. This is a little bit of an I wasn't really sure with this lineup, but I think accuracy-wise, this should be able to favor them. It's just the ballers are performing much better today, at least overall, and I'm honestly surprised at that. Because for the first two picks, it looks like, well, mostly the hybrid pick. It looked like, yeah, they were better, but not by much. But after that, like the first pick and the others, it seemed like they were just outperforming themselves by so much. And that's really important to their potential path to the victory.
Honestly, Blade, with these trill transitions, you definitely just don't want to be dropping a couple of 200s. But just look at the consistency from ballers. 99.8, actually, boy, he does drop a few grades there, but again, so the higher overall average. Double 99.7. Unfortunately, it's just Log slightly falling a bit behind with that 99.32, but all players are still keeping extremely consistent, as I do not really see any signs of more misjudgments. But those anchors, it can definitely catch a player out, especially if they hit it a bit too early or too late. Again, coming in at 2 minutes 51 as well, it's going to be a pure, it's going to be a test for your stamina as well.
And now it's starting to get, it's starting to, like, the difference is really starting to increase. The consistency, very impressive for ballers. Once again, no one misses on those anchors. Log may have gotten a few 200s, but I think that's not going to be too detrimental. This difference is still nothing, as there's still a few more roly, streamy patterns and all that. And if that's going to be the case, I think the ballers might just have secured it.
Yeah, I definitely do think of that as well, as, you know, we're just getting into the backhand map. Well, even though I do still think a miss could swing back the lead, but we're just running out of time, and it doesn't even seem like that. All players showing no signs of any misjudgments or combo breaks as well, as we only have less than 100k of the map left. It does look like ballers are going to be snagging this victory. I'm going to be threatening match point against Splendor Tranquil Waters.
15,000 points of difference. Wow, they massively improved that, getting a double 1x200. I mean, in the previous, on the time they played it, they had like 8 200, so they improved this all by a huge amount. consistency was also very impressive. Like, everyone had a full combo. It would have taken, like, a 994 or 995 for log 45vs for this to even be a win. Now, 1-4 on the brink of elimination. What are they going to be doing? I think the safest route is, it has to be hybrid, I think.
Yep. And now, without threatening of match point, it does seem like Splendor Tranquil Waters are going to have to pick extremely wisely, as this pick may be their last, as we do see in the tournament. Okay, so it does seem like now that I will unfortunately be having to say goodbye temporarily for this commentary, as I will have to step down from the commentary booth temporarily. So joining in for this is going to be Epic Man 2. Unfortunately, he was running a small bit late, but for now, as I was going to be subbing in for him, but for now, please welcome Epic Man 2 and take care.
I closed my Fortnite to be here.
Okay, so
yeah, what's broken?
What's up?
Yeah.
Right, now, what do you think? What do you think should they pick? Now that they're in this position.
What do I think that they should pick? Personally, I feel like they haven't really like used much of the hybrids yet. Like, we still have the Pseudo Gap and Glorious like available for use, as we still have like, and I feel like it could fall into the advantage of like Ivor team. However, with the sort of skill boost that Bowlers has been going through, potentially this is like already like a really dangerous situation for Splendor of Tranquil Waters, assuming this is in the loser's bracket, right?
This is loser's bracket, you would be correct.
Yeah. So yeah. Ultimately, as it stands now, Splendor of Tranquil Waters has like one last shot to be able to like try and be able to keep their tournament lives in this tournament. Considering that there isn't much options left, they have to really start like pushing and exhausting their options to be able to like try and force the tiebreaker to make it through. However, as we would have seen, grounded of a team Bowlers is, it does really seem really slim, and that there has to be like one spark of hope like left at the door in front of them, which I do have faith in.
Let's see. Well, also, I just think hybrid's way to go. Yeah?
Oh yeah. Also, can I just mention how one of my maps was used in the warm-up? I'm quite surprised at that. I was like a bit late to see that, but thanks to whoever did it. I still love the song, by the way. Tea from my guard. Anyway, you were saying? Sorry.
Yeah, so they're taking the time out. I just noticed that right now, which is really good. You're in the 4-1 situation. What? I don't know what to feel about this pick. Because the one pick that you really won on was hybrid, and you lost an Ellen map. While this is a different kind of Ellen in comparison to Formless Canvas, I still don't know if this is the best pick to make, especially considering with how much better the Bowlers are playing today.
Yeah. Yeah, as it stands, this is like a bit of a gamble, as we can see, based off like all the other scores that Splendor of Tranquil Waters as a team has done like in their previous matches and in qualifiers especially. However, this is like the more coordination-based pick, so like although it is not as like intense as maps such as Love It from qualifiers and also Emma Michi from, although this is like not as easy as Emma Michi and Love It, this is definitely gonna be like really dangerous for them especially. So if they're going to be taking this one last gamble to be able to try and sneak their next point from this match point, then they really need to like sort of commit to it. They really need to be able to like try and make sure that they can pull the lead over and then start the reverse sweep streak from here.
Let's see.
As we get into the match, the scores are already flickering back and forth for the rather simple LN patterns with a little sprinkle of triplets and also shields. Only a few hundred points apart. The lead is like slowly favoring Splendor of Tranquil Waters, although they have a very like slim lead compared to Ballers. The score itself like taking a bit of drops like to go into Ballers' favor while it almost instantly flickers back to Splendor of Tranquil Waters' lead. Now being like about 2,000 points ahead, Seimitsu holding immensely great accuracy in this map, potentially like the best accuracy so far in the map. However, there is still a lot of the map left. Only there they may be 3,000 points ahead now. However, like they may be 4,000 points ahead now, especially. However, despite that, the lead is like growing, especially. How, but there is still like a lot of time for tides to change, for there to be yet another shift in this match as a whole.
See, the thing is, it's mainly because of Gaiety 2 noobs dropping accuracy, not to mention Saimitsu far ahead of everyone else, and Log 45 VS doing an amazing job countering Gaiety 2 noobs accuracy. This is exactly the kind of win that they'll need. But now we're approaching one of the more difficult parts, the most difficult part to release, I'd have to say. And Gaiety 2 noob finds a drop, that's what I was talking about. And now I think the clear path will be going to Splendor, hopefully trying to counter everything that just happened, but Log finds a miss!
With the two teams having traded misses now, as we get into like one of the harder parts of the song, the map is slowly closing out. Splendor of Tranquil Waters maintaining their 20,000 point lead now. Log taking another miss, however, that's not gonna do it as they finally break another point in this match towards the during Bowlers' match point. See, all the scores like being relatively like similar. Seimitsu holding a 990k score with like the best ratio of only 286 points, not too far behind by only about 3,000 points, so, which is commendable to say the least.
Yeah, 3,200 is certainly a very good display of LN ACK ability. Gaiety 2 noob and Log 45 VS was the main difference, though. Very clutch performance from Log there. Saimitsu definitely led the charge, but Splendor as a team just did much better in comparison to the Baller.
Yep, for sure. And as we and for the next pick, which is going to be done by Ballers, is going to be none other than Glorious, which is Hybrid Free. So this would be a rather interesting map to like see how things play out on, especially since the song itself it's rather well known because well it's been mapped by a bunch of people already. But like with the fact that some teams have played it already, Ballers especially, Pointy having getting a 999 a 975k. And also, however, in the previous matches, especially for Splendor of Tranquil Waters, it may appear that Seimitsu and LeFluffy have also gone like relatively good scores on this as well, which is going to be the same lineup as prior. So it would be pretty interesting to see how this turns out, considering that the teams have like similar scores. So definitely, if they're So, it could go like in many different ways, so yeah. as everyone's gives out their good lucks and have fun, we are going to be going into the map now. Excited to see how this turns out.
All right. Let's see how this is going to go. I don't think this was the pick that Baller should have made. Like, I think they should have stuck to Ryze, because I thought the hybrids would have benefited Splendor more than the Baller. Right now, the difference will favor Splendor slightly because of that accuracy lead and that early miss. But it's not gonna be too much, as LaFluffy and Gaeditu tie each other up. But Sangmitu has a very slight edge over Poity, and that's been the difference. Now we're approaching the Ellens, but Sangmitu drops! The Minijax mixed with the Ellens could really make your wrists unstable. Now here we go with the Ryze section, and it does not look like it's gonna affect anyone. The difference is so close though. Now we're approaching LNs, which you'd think it would benefit Splendor, but no! It actually makes them lose on score.
With only like half of the map left, Baller is now maintaining a 6,000 point lead, which is beating out Splendor's previous lead of about a few thousand points from the start of this match, from this pick. It may seem that we are now approaching the latter quarter of the map. So definitely there is a lot of like room for things to shift. Although now this is potentially the all or nothing sort of moment for Ballers. Potentially this could be the last pick of this whole round. This entire match.
Wait a second. They're dropping accuracy. The Baller's dropping accuracy. If any miss happens, it could still shift. But it doesn't look like it's going to happen. And the Ballers pull it off, I think. They do. Oh my goodness. Congratulations to the Ballers for advancing to the next round. Looking at the accuracy, I think 200 slightly favors Splendor, but the ratio goes to the Ballers, and definitely that miscount favored Splendor. Congratulations to both teams, and what an amazing job. But the Ballers is going to be your victor for this match with a 5-2 win, punching their ticket to the semifinals round.
Yeah, for sure. Congrats to all the players of this round, and we're unfortunately going to be having to say goodbye to Splendor of Tranquil Waters. This was definitely like a bit of a fight for them to pull over, considering that this was especially on a Monday, which is not really as common. Ballers is going to be punching their ticket to the semifinals losers bracket. And as it may seem, that
they'll be facing... I'm just gonna guess that team has Poketwine on the name. wait, let's see.
Yeah, it's Poken Kar.
Okay, Poken Kojuju, that one.
Yeah, it's that one, yeah. I swear I commentated for that team earlier. Like, I think it was in round of 32 or something like that, yeah. So, this would definitely be an interesting match to see. Considering that both teams are, like, rather rounded, etc. So, yeah. Do be sure to keep on the lookout for that.
Mm-hmm. But, yeah, thank you so much for commentating with me, Epic Man 2, and also the Nightcore for commentating this as well. Meanwhile, yeah. for Sagiri, thank you as well for reffing, and also for Ethan for streaming, and thank you once again to the players as well, and also to everyone who viewed this match. We hope that you enjoyed the quarterfinals round. See you next time for the semifinals map pool showcase.
Yep, see ya, and have a good day, everyone. Bye.